Turns out that most, if not all, lean PCOS patients start out in their 20s with high androgens, high AMH, but then in the late 20s, early 30s, something happens to the androgen levels. And it is a very quick thing that is happening. Suddenly, their androgen levels are dropping rather precipitously, while the AMH levels still continue in the usual slow decline. So what you end up seeing is a discrepancy between AMH and androgen levels. While usually patients with PCOS who have high AMH also have high androgen levels, suddenly these patients either have normal androgen levels or even low androgen levels. So we basically defined a new PCOS phenotype, or I should better say the old lean PCOS phenotype of young years, at older ages turns into a lean hypoandrogenic rather than hyperandrogenic PCOS phenotype. And that has never been known. Now that is very important because in endocrinology there is something that is called receptor memory. Hormones work through receptors, and the androgens work through the testosterone receptor in the ovary on the granulosa cells. Those receptors still remember the high testosterone levels of younger years. And therefore, these lean PCOS patients who in the 30s or early 40s come for infertility not only need to be brought back to normal testosterone levels, but they actually need a little higher testosterone levels because their ovaries are still remembering the good testosterone levels of their young years. So that's the first point that is important. So androgen supplementation, in most cases with DHEA, in these women is highly effective. Bringing back the testosterone levels, kicking in the ovaries, and suddenly patients who have failed in multiple IVF cycles at many centers suddenly get pregnant, actually even marginally at better rates than classical PCOS patients.